The IRCK Interfaith Integrity Award 2024 is an initiative that was created within USAID USAWA program to provide a platform for youth in the five targeted counties by USAID USAWA to showcase their talent, to showcase their innovative approaches on how to reduce fraud, waste and abuse in the health sector. And today was a great day for the youth to showcase their talent through skits, poems, songs, pictorials on how we can reduce fraud, waste and abuse in the health sector. Tusijeruhusu ufisadi kwa afya zetu. Tuungane mimi na wewe tuseme no. Sisi ni mashujaa shupavu tunataka timiza ndoto zetu. Atuamini tunaweza, tunaweza. I was one of the judges to the just concluded youth competition on corruption in our health sector. Basically, we were so entertained. The edutainment factor was actually covered. There was some challenges in terms of presentations from different participants, but we believe with our comments given, they're going to improve and the galas are going to be better. And how I wish these competitions to involve more youth in all the counties, because we feel as Mombasa and Kilifi, we could have more items or we could have more participants so that this message could be passed at a wide range.
I'd like to highlight two things about today. First, the multitude of talent that we have witnessed today and the importance of young people taking part in this process. We have seen a lot of creativity from young people in using different styles of messaging to spread awareness against corruption, and not just corruption. The categories that we have specified under this project, that is fraud, wastage, and abuse. We have seen skits, we have seen spoken word, we have seen dramatized choral verses, we have seen musical pieces. Creativity has been at the center of today's showcase, and youth, the average age I think was about 24, 25, going lower, even up to 22, thereabout. We saw some young people from Mombasa coming out well-versed in different styles of music. We saw rap music, we saw prose music, we saw music with a blend of Swahili in it, and all that just attests to the maximum talent that we see amongst young people. I feel that these young people have not yet been given sufficient space and platform to be able to explore to the greatest potential their creativity, especially in messaging. And this is maybe just a call for many more of these projects to come, so that young people are able to use their skills, skill sets, and learned talent to be able to preach the different messages against different vices and not just corruption in our respective societies. Si afya ni haki ya kila moja. Sasa kwa nini niwekwe kando nikingoja? Kuna mgonjwa mwenye kuna mtoto anaitwa Hope, lakini akiondo hospitalini anakosa tumaini. Uhai unakatika sababu vifaa vimeharibika. Kwa nini mfumo umevunjika? Si kwa sasa, wacha nianze kulonga na kulongoa bila Kiswahili kukibananga. Sasa ni wakati wa kupambana na si kulumbana, kukomesha ufisadi, kuleta mabadiliko katika sekta ya afya.
I'm a poet. My stage name najulikana kama The Poetic Hunter. Okay, hii siku ya leo ambayo ni siku ya tamasha la vijana, as in competition, ambayo every artist ambao walikuwa nafaa hapa washindane, as in tukienda na theme ya corruption in the health sector. Okay, mimi kama artist, kitu yenye imenigusa sana ikanifanya paka ni kuje kwa hii competition, as in corruption, it is something that is there. So ni vitu ambazo tunapitia kama sisi na kama wananchi pia ni wazazi wetu. Yani ni mengi ambayo napitia hospitalini. Ya ukifika hospitalini hakuna madawa, unaambiwa ungoje. Sasa wengi wanaaga kwa sababu ya hiyo. So hii ndio imenisukuma mpaka nikafika hapa, ndio I speak out my feelings on this issue.
Why is it important for youth to be at the center of this fight? It's because youth are the, I don't want to use this cliche term that youth are the future, youth are the now. We have seen currently what's happening in Kenya, the Gen Z taking center stage and demanding for accountability from government. Evidence of what we have seen today, a general just overview of what the day has been like. It has been a successful day, full of a lot of talent and showcase, and most importantly, a lot of learning and a lot of lessons. Young people have been able to give us lessons of how rot in our respective public institutions, hospitals, service delivery, how the highest bidder is able to access services, how impunity has been able to be entrenched in so much so that the service providers were supposed to be giving these services and products free of charge, prioritizing their own private entities. And that calls for changes in policy and in law enforcement, so that perpetrators and culprits and those illicit loopholes for financial flows to be able to be plugged. And so young people have not only been at the center of today's showcase, but they have given us hope that if they themselves can take the mantle and show us all these messages, then it simply means that given an opportunity, they would be the very first ambassadors of the various levels of accountability that we demand from government. And so let us give youth a chance, let us involve them in programming and not just invite them to rubber stamp ideas, let us involve them in the co-creation of these ideas so that there is ownership, there's inclusivity, and there is, you know, goodwill in the implementation of these activities. Thank you so much.